This has been
such an amazing experience, and I'm so glad to share. And I'm just so proud of all of us. Hashtag community for sure. Thank you guys, but I love all of you.
We've lifted each other up.
I feel stronger.
Motivated.
Empowered.
Inspired.
To feel community again.
Community.
Community.
I'm ready to connect.
I love performing.
Gratitude.
I'm still standing.
You can never know what it's like. Your blood like winter freezes just like ice. And there's a cold and lonely light that shines from you. You'll wind up like the wreck you hide behind that mask you use. And did you think this fool could never win? Well, look at me, I'm coming back again. I got a taste of love in a simple way. And if you need to know while I'm still standing, you just fade away. Don't you know I'm still standing better than I ever did? Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. And I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces. Made were meant to cut me down. And if my love was just a circus, you'd be a clown by now. No, I'm still standing better than I ever did. Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces of my life without you.
Good evening. Of all the many remarkable programs and performances at the Music Center, Spotlight is one of my favorites. 3 years ago, we were on the stage of Walt Disney Concert Hall for a live grand finale performance, not knowing that would be our last live Spotlight finale until tonight. Despite our shuttered venues, the amazing spirit of the Spotlight community and our incredible students continue to shine. Over the last 2 years, Spotlight offered Southern California students hope, joy, and a way to stay connected and inspired. In fact, over 3,000 students participated in the Spotlight program through auditions, master classes. We even launched a virtual Spotlight Academy that reaches thousands of students year-round, and we held two successful virtual grand finale events. And now, at long last, we are back! So it is with great pleasure that I welcome you to the 34th annual Music Center Spotlight Grand Finale performance. Having been a ballet dancer with American Ballet Theatre when I was younger, I know firsthand the importance of arts programs that recognize, support, and prepare young artists. While Spotlight helps students hone their craft, it also teaches critically important life skills such as determination, hard work, resilience, and self-assurance. These skills will carry them far in life, allowing them to succeed in today's world, regardless of the path they follow. Spotlight is free to all high school students in Southern California. It provides young artists a once-in-a-lifetime learning experience. Yes. Thank you to all our teachers and artists and community partners for sharing your time, talent, and energy with these extraordinary students. Thank you as well to the amazing Jerry Gale and her outstanding team. This marks Jerry's 20th year as the director of Spotlight. Her love for this program is infectious and shines through in everything she does. Jerry, we are all very lucky to have you. Spotlight and our other arts learning programs would not be possible without the support of our generous donors, many of whom are here tonight. Yes. Your incredible dedication, enthusiasm, and financial support allows Spotlight and other Music Center arts learning programs to flourish. We are so grateful that you recognize the power of the arts to transform the lives of young people and to make our world a better place. So, now it is my pleasure to introduce one of our grand prize finalists in dance, Tegan Chu, and one of our grand prize finalists in acting, Michael Davis.
I've always felt like the Music Center is part of the community, inviting and inclusive of its neighbors, students like me, offering performances and programs that I never thought were within reach, giving me to opportunities I never knew were possible.
Spotlight and other Music Center arts learning programs benefit both students like me and our communities, now and in the future, and are all possible thanks to your generosity and ongoing efforts.
Thank you to the Edgerton Foundation and the Glen Haven and Shalom Memorial Park for your support.
Thank you to Spotlight Principal Benefactors Dr. Martin Balzer and the Hearst Foundations.
Thank you to Helen and Peter Bing, who were an early and a key part of our Spotlight family. The Bings are principal scholarship benefactors who have underwritten student scholarships for the Spotlight program's entire 34 years.
Thank you. I'm going to UCLA in the fall, so I know the scholarship money will make a big difference.
Thank you to Fred Roberts for his significant endowment gift, which named Jerry Gale's position as the Frederick Roberts Director of the Spotlight Program.
We also want to give a special thank you to the Music Center's anchor sponsors, Gloria Kaufman, Cindy Misikowski, and Tina and Jerry Moss, whose commitment... give them applause. Yeah, go ahead. Whose commitment to the arts and the transformational giving help advance all of our work. Now, before we start this performance in celebration of the 2022 Grand Prize finalists, we are also here to applaud this year's other talented applicants, over 3,000 of them.
And the more than 50,000 young performers who have participated in the Spotlight Arts Training Program over the last 35 years. Let's give them a round of applause.
On behalf of the entire Music Center family, thank you for your support and for joining us tonight to celebrate this talented group of young artists. Please enjoy the 34th annual Music Center Spotlight Grand Finale performance.
Please welcome our hosts, principal dancer with the New York City Ballet, Tyler Peck, and 2016 Spotlight alum, whose credits include the Oscar-nominated film The Tender Bar, Rhenzy, Feliz.
We're so excited to be your host for the 34th annual Spotlight Grand Finale. I'm a California native and started my career in the arts as a young dancer right here in Los Angeles.
And I was an acting Spotlight Grand Prize finalist way back in 2016.
Way back?
Yeah, right, not so way back, but it's a funny thing, a long time ago, but it also feels kind of like yesterday. Except, you know what we didn't have when I was a Grand Prize finalist?
What?
That super cool opening number. Did you see them out there? Michael was having the time of his life.
Many of the students we're going to meet auditioned over several years for Spotlight before making it to the grand finale. And one of this year's finalists participated all 4 years of high school. Tonight, you will see how their perseverance paid off.
These students come from all across the region, as close as a few blocks from here and as far away as San Diego County. They have put in time, effort, and in some cases, clocked serious mileage to participate in Spotlight.
And while tonight's performances might be the end of the year-long Spotlight program for these amazing young artists, it's also the beginning of a future where anything is possible.
So let's get started. Our first performer is one of our grand prize finalists in non-classical voice, Bella Abelhosen. Her third year participating in Spotlight, Bella is 17 and a junior at Chaminade High School. She thanks her teachers, Julia Gregory and Yvette Bishop, for the love and support they have shown her on her creative journey. Let's meet Bella.
I fell in love with singing when I was 3 years old. My great aunt and I would sing together at the piano with our whole family every Christmas. And so I started taking lessons with her when I was like three. Performing honestly makes me feel powerful. I can be myself fully on stage. Whenever I feel the light hit my face, I feel a sense of comfort and a sense of home, and I know that's where I'm supposed to be. Besides singing, I love to write. My best friend Ellie and I love writing together. We write skits, TV shows, movies. We started writing when we were 12, and our dream is to be head writers on SNL together one day. Something that not a lot of people know about me is that I used to be a cheerleader, and now I'm a cheerleading coach at my old elementary school. I love cheerleading. It was a big passion of mine when I was younger, but I had to stop being a cheerleader because I wanted to do theater. But now I get to do theater and I get to be a cheer coach, and it's really fun. Go Otters! Spotlight is really awesome because I get to have all these professional experiences like the one I'm having now as a high schooler, which is rare. It's my dream to perform on the Amundsen stage, and so the fact that I get to do that, I'm so, so, so grateful. Bella? Listen to me, you got this. Don't forget what you're gonna do on stage. Remember your stuff, remember your choreo, remember your lines, and remember to have fun, because that's what it's all about. Have fun.
Now playing the show's Arrange Anything for a Price classmate, Bella sings Nobody Steps on Kafritz from the 1967 Broadway musical Henry, Sweet Henry. Please welcome Bella Abelhosen.
She was out to get me, but I got her first. When she got malicious, she happened to pick a kid. Could be twice as vicious and twice as vindictive. I am rough and I am ruthless. Though it's tough, the bitter truth is nobody steps on Kafritz. If they do, then they must be crushed. Most of the world are half-wits, and their laughter will soon be hushed. A superior mental IQ makes inferior minds dislike you. If the world starts a ruckus and all of them run amok, it's to step on a Kafritz. My friends, you're never too young to be rotten. too young to be hostile. Never too young to be just plain crummy. You can catch on in a wink. Be a rat. Be a fink. I'm a monster. I am miserable. And I'm glad it's plainly miserable. Nobody steps on Caffarets. If they do, then they must be crushed. Out of my way, you halfwits. Nobody steps on Caffarets.
Wow, nothing's getting in the way of Caffarets or Bella. Now, let's meet our next performer, a grand prize finalist in dance, Dylan Blackburn. Her first year in Spotlight, Dylan is 15 and a sophomore at Canyon High School. She wants to thank her teachers, Molly Long and Autumn Miller, for their training and support. Now let's get to know Dylan.
I started dancing when I was 7 years old because my sister started dancing before I did and I just wanted to be like her.
I love dancing because it's such an amazing way to express everything that I'm feeling. If I'm ever feeling happy or sad, it's just a super good way to get out all those feelings on the dance floor. I dance between 25 to 30 hours a week. My favorite style of dance is jazz. For me, I think performing jazz is like more intense. I feel like I can just move my body in the way that like the music is telling me to. I would say I'm definitely competitive. If I wasn't competitive, I feel like I would just not set goals for myself. Setting a goal for myself before I go on stage, whether it being just like having a clean performance or feeling good about my performance after, that just motivates me to give it all I have on stage. My mom used to be a dancer and my dad is a golf pro. I think dancing definitely like plays into golf because of all the coordination. I have good coordination compared to my dad, I think. One of the things I love about Spotlight is seeing the variety of dances and dancers. There was a lot of different styles that I saw that I've never seen before, and it was super cool. I've learned a lot from watching other dancers. It feels so amazing to be part of the Spotlight family, just making so many connections that I wouldn't have gotten to make. I'm super excited about performing at the Music Center. I've never been there or performed there, so it's crazy that this will be my first time. My message to you, Dylan, as you're about to walk on stage right now, is to just enjoy every single moment of being on that stage and have fun performing to all those people. You got this.
Performing Haunted, please welcome Dylan Blackburn.
It's what you do, it's what you see. I know if I'm haunting you, you must be haunting me. It's where we go, it's where we'll be. I know if I'm onto you, I'm onto you, onto you. You must be onto me. Where will it be?
if I'm haunting you, you must be haunting me. It's where we go, it's where we'll be. I know if I'm onto you, I'm onto you, onto you.
That was incredible. Reminds me I need to stretch more often. These incredible performances just keep on coming. Now I would like to introduce one of our grand prize finalists in classical voice, Oscar Yum. Oscar is a junior at Flint Ridge Preparatory School, and this is his second year participating in Spotlight. Oscar thanks his music teachers, Eric Liflin and Joshua Tan, for the endless guidance and inspiration they provide. Let's meet Oscar.
I've been singing for as long as I can remember, in the car, to the radio, just wherever there's music, I was singing along. Singing is such a wonderful expression of emotions. It portrays so many feelings and moods that are difficult to portray otherwise. The first step of learning a song is learning the meaning, what the story is. I think it's the most important part, because without a story and without the meaning of the words, you're just singing notes. When I'm standing on that stage and just singing, I just get lost. It's like a buzz of adrenaline and of joy and happiness. One of my big hobbies is painting these little miniatures for this tabletop war game called Warhammer 40K. It's pretty nerdy, but I love just sitting down for sometimes hours at a time and just shutting everything out and just painting these little things. I'm really inspired by my maternal grandfather and my paternal grandmother. They both came to this country from Korea under very difficult circumstances, and they went through so much for me to be here. They sacrificed their lives, their homeland, and I hope that I make them proud and that they look down on me and can see that everything that they've done was worth it, and that I am the product of the American dream that they fought so hard to make true. I just hope that they know that they live on through me. I can do stuff like this because of them. This experience is so incredible and so empowering for young musicians. Oscar, you got this. You're gonna kill it. And you're gonna remember your words because you studied them, and you remember what they mean, and you're just gonna love every second of it.
Tonight, Oscar performs a piece for solo voice based on a poem which makes the analogy between trout fishing and young women caught by the lure of love. Performing Dee Farella and accompanied by Dr. Louise Thomas, please welcome Oscar Yum.
Des muntern Fischleins Borde im klaren Bächlein zu. Ein den Fische mit der Rute wohl an dem Ufer stand und saß mit kaltem Blute, wie sich das Fischlein wand. Solang dem Wasser helle, so dacht ich nicht gebricht, so fängt er die Forelle mit seiner Angel nicht. So fängt er die Forelle mit seiner Angel nicht. Doch endlich ward dem Diebe die Zeit zu lang. Er macht das Bächlein tückisch trübe, und eh ich es gedacht, so zückte seine Rute. Das Fischlein zappelt dran, und ich mit regem Blute sah die Betrogne an. Und ich mit regem Blute sah die Betrogne an.
Wow, his voice is so good, he makes trout fishing sound good. All right. Our first grand prize finalist in acting is Lauren May. Her second year participating in Spotlight, Lauren is 16 and a junior at the Orange County School of the Arts. She sends love and thanks to her teachers, John Walcott and Stephanie Dorian Smith, for their support and their guidance. Let's meet Lauren.
I started acting when I was probably 3 years old, just screaming my heart out to Hannah Montana in the living room. I love acting because of the empathy aspect of it and the opportunity that you get to share stories with other people, teach people about humanity, and have like a vulnerable experience with somebody. A challenge that I've faced both as an artist and as a person is learning about my own identity in the process, specifically my Asian American identity, and figuring out what it's like to create art in an underrepresented community, and figuring out the stories that I want to tell and how I want to tell those stories to not only help learn about myself, but also represent my community. I think that there's, I would say, a lack of representation in Asian American art, so there's something exciting about that challenge, about getting to pave the way for other people, and I'm very excited for the rest of my journey. Aside from acting, I love crocheting little dolls. I think it's so cool to like basically create life. I just love getting to create something that's like very unique and its own thing. As an artist and as a young person, Spotlight really taught me the aspect of community in your art and what it means to acknowledge somebody's brilliance. I know that I'm here with so many amazing artists, and it's so cool to see people my age and young people being passionate and being extremely good at the things that they do. Thank you so much for letting me be a part of this program and for fostering young artists. I think it's really important to support the people who have stories to tell and the next generation of people who are going to be risk takers. This experience has been like no other, and I really appreciate you. Hi, you. Congratulations for making it here. You're here, so just take a deep breath and be present. You've done the work. I'm proud of you, and trust yourself. I'll see you soon.
In a scene from Twilight, Los Angeles, 1992, Anna Deavere Smith's Tony-nominated play about the Los Angeles riots, Lauren plays the role of Miss Young Soon Han, a Korean woman reflecting in the light of the Rodney King verdict on the pain she's experienced as an immigrant in America. Please welcome Lauren May.
Until last year, I used to believe America was the best. I still do. I don't deny that now because I am a victim. But as the year ends in 92, I really realized that the Korean immigrants were left out from this society and we were nothing. Why do we have to be left out? Many African Americans who never work, they get the minimum amount of money to survive. We don't get any. Because we have a house, and we have a car, and we are high taxpayers. Where do I find justice? Black people, they believe they won by the trial. They got their rights by destroying the lives of innocent Korean merchants. And I wonder if that is really justice to get their rights another way. I was swallowing the bitterness, sitting here alone, watching them. And in a way, I was happy for them. At least they got something back.
Having just had the 30th anniversary of the LA riots, those words are still resonating. With every spotlight performance, these talented young artists entertain, enlighten, and move us. Now let's turn to our next performer, our grand prize finalist in ballet, Justin Padilla. This is Justin's second year participating in Spotlight. A high school sophomore, he is 15 and homeschooled. Justin thanks his teachers, Dimitri Kuliv and Crystal Matsuyama-Sai, for their outstanding training and support. Now let's get to know Justin.
I started dancing when I was 9 or 10 years old because my friend brought me to her Bring a Friend a Dance Day, and then I fell in love with it. I just love dancing because it's what I'm passionate about. I love showing people what I'm good at. I love ballet because of the structure of it. It gives me such an amazing foundation to pursue other dance styles. Like contemporary helps my movement quality. When I step out on the stage, I step into a different world. I don't think about how I look, I just feel. Through dance, I feel like I can express myself because there is a lot of storytelling through the movement. I get a lot of my inspiration from dancing in the shower. I usually just use my arms and I just like turn in the I turn in the shower. I think of choreography ideas, and then if I get to my room later and I like the idea, I go on with it. I love to dance, but I also love to choreograph because when I choreograph, it really just is me and not anybody else. And I could be myself. One of the biggest challenges I've had to overcome was my confidence and dealing with people that weren't very nice. I was just bullied because I guess dancing isn't the most masculine thing, but it is what I love, so. The way I overcame this was my friends and all their good energy towards me and being very supportive. Aside from dancing, I love to read. Reading inspires my dance because I don't really read chapter books, they're more comic books. The covers and all the drawings are so beautiful. Some of the things I've taken away from Spotlight are all the friendships I've made and all the feedback that I've gotten. I feel like I really took that to heart and I really applied it to my performance. Hey Justin, I know you're sitting in the wings right now. I hope you're not that nervous. I hope you're pumped and ready to go on stage. I hope you smile.
From From the ballet based on the 1772 novel The Devil in Love, performing the male variation from Satinella Pas de Deux, it is my pleasure to introduce Justin Padilla.
The grace and the strength Justin just displayed was amazing, right? And considering Justin and all of these artists are at the start of their careers, think of what they're capable of becoming.
The next Misty Copeland, or a future Josh Groban, maybe another Adam Lambert.
It could happen.
The world is waiting for them, which is why your support is more important than ever. So we want to take a moment to encourage your continued support and to salute you for what you've already done to start me and all of the other past, present, and future Spotlight participants on our way.
Thank you.
In fact, we Spotlight alumni are everywhere. You see us on stage, film, and TV. You hear us singing your favorite songs or watch us conducting a beloved symphony. Let's tell them what some of our Spotlight alumni have been up to.
Sage McNeely made the top 20 on American Idol. Ben Ross starred in Tick, Tick, Boom, and Darian Selman joined the Royal Ballet.
Mason Alexander starred on Broadway in Hedwig and the Angry Inch. Michelle Tsai joined the LA Phil.
And both Adam Levy and Derek Klena are starring in Moulin Rouge on Broadway.
Jennifer Grace became a principal dancer in the Colorado Ballet, while another Jennifer Stahl, is a principal dancer with the San Francisco Ballet.
Now, Oscar, I'm going to put you to work again introducing the next performer. Stage is yours.
Our grand prize finalist jazz instrumental is Evan Dexter.
Evan is 16 years old, a jazz trombonist, composer, and a junior at the LA County High School of the Arts, or as we in SoCal call it, LACSA!
This is Evan's first time as a Spotlight participant, and he thanks Alex Isles and Scott Whitfield, two of his dedicated and patient teachers, for helping him start his journey in jazz.
Let's get to know Evan.
I started playing trombone when I was 11 in sixth grade middle school band class. That was kind of just the instrument that was given to me, but I actually really enjoyed playing it, so that's kind of where it started. I guess I've always really admired like the trombone like sound, especially in like a big band setting. And I also really like the slide mechanic. I feel like the trombone is kind of my voice, and I feel like I can really speak my ideas out and express my emotions. I come from a very musical background because a lot of my family are musicians. Sometimes me and my dad will sit down and play standards or whatever, and my dad will play piano. It's cool that we're just able to do that. Aside from music, I also have a really big connection to Japan. I've just really fallen in love with the culture because it's so like minimalistic. All the houses and stuff, they only have like what they need. That's the lifestyle that I want to live personally. I think Japan has had a lot of influence on my music as well. I grew up playing a lot of Nintendo, and so a lot of that music has also had influence on the music that I write and compose. I think my favorite part about composing and arranging is that it's just like a blank slate. You just have so much freedom, and you can really do whatever you want. Hearing my music played by real musicians for the first time is really cool because it sounds a lot better than like the MIDI playback. One of the things that has been most valuable to me was the feedback that Spotlight sent me, because it's this really long and detailed letter of everything that sounded good and then stuff that needs improvement. And I really cherished that feedback, and I would look back at it all the time. And that's really what I had in mind when I was doing my live auditions for Spotlight. Evan, it's me, your past self. Before you go up on stage and perform, I just want to remind you to not get nervous and don't get in your own head. And just go up there and enjoy yourself, because the audience is just there to listen to some good music. So just provide.
Now performing Alice in Wonderland by Sammy Fain, please welcome Evan Dexter.
Thank you.
I love that Alice in Wonderland piece. It's got me smiling like a Cheshire cat. Okay, now I want to introduce our next performer, our second grand prize finalist in classical voice, Leah Zhang. A first-timer to Spotlight, 17-year-old Leah is a junior at Canyon Crest Academy who hopes to have a college career exploring the intersection of music, philosophy, and artificial intelligence. So wow, we better watch out. She's going to take over the world. She's thankful for teachers Zepping Tsai and Kathleen Martin as she continues studying music and the other worlds it opens up to her. Let's meet Leah.
I started singing lessons in first grade because my dad recorded a video of me singing, and it was so bad that I cried from listening to the recording, so he sent me to singing lessons to improve. I love classical music because I feel like these songs transcend generations and also languages, and they last forever. I think the combination of poetry and music with art songs is really cool because it's like you're taking two art forms that could exist separately, but then you're combining it to create something even more cathartic. When I step on stage, I do have pretty bad stage fright, so it is like fear at first, but I feel like once I start singing, I feel much better, and then I can get lost in the music, especially when I know a piece really well. Aside from singing, I love philosophy and studying machine learning. Machine learning, in simple words, is basically a subset of artificial intelligence that focuses on teaching machines programs without explicit code. I think I'm just really interested in seeing what the future will look like, and I want to be a part of improvements in technology and just improving people's lives. I hope we're not run over by robots in 5 years, but I think that technology will definitely become a bigger part of our lives and just automation in general. I think my number one takeaway from Spotlight has just been the breakthrough with my stage fright from the semifinal auditions. There's probably multiple reasons for that, but one of them was just feeling more confident, and that includes like wearing something you feel confident in and feeling ready for the auditions because you're choosing like a piece that you feel you know really well. The Spotlight masterclasses were incredible because I was able to see other young singers perform, and I haven't been able to see that very often. In the past few months, I've seen such a drastic difference in both my singing and also just my performing as a whole, and I feel like Spotlight has such a big role in that. Leah, you don't need to be afraid. Just go out on stage and perform. You got this.
Singing Rossini's song-like aria of a lover promising eternal devotion to her beloved, please welcome Leah Zhang performing La Promessa.
Oh.
Brava! That was absolutely beautiful.
And her interests highlight just how different the experiences, training, and passions are of our Spotlight students.
They are young people who are not only pursuing their artistic dreams while in high school studying and taking tests, but they also have hobbies and sports and busy family lives.
These things make them well-rounded people and even better artists, which is evident as we watch these performances tonight.
Now, our next performer, who you met earlier with Rachel, is our second grand prize finalist in acting, Michael Davis.
He is an 18-year-old senior at the San Diego School of Creative and Performing Arts, and he is a first-time Spotlight participant. He thanks his acting teachers, Roxanne Carrasco and Shauna Marquis, for shaping him into the artist he is today. Let's hear from Michael.
I started acting when I was in seventh grade. My best friend said I should audition for a musical, and I did. And ever since then, I've been auditioning for plays and musicals and loving every bit of it. What I love about acting is that as an audience member, I can go to not only escape whatever is happening in my life, and join someone else on their journey. But as an actor performing, I can help provide that escape and be there for someone. And even if I don't know what's going on for them, I can still offer support. One of my favorite roles that I've played is Captain Hook in Peter Pan. I was reading the book right after I was cast, and I read that in Neverland, there is no concept of gender. And I found that fascinating, and I wanted to really dive in and explore that. So I used my Captain Hook as truly an exploration of a genderless society, and I was able to learn how to show love differently and explore how that was and how it works for me, and it was a very informative time for myself. Something else I love beside acting is music. I began to write music. It started off as a sort of therapeutic project, but I just grew to love it. Another passion of mine is thrifting and searching for vintage clothing. I found myself very attracted to 70s clothing, like the butterfly collars I am a sucker for. I just like playing dress up, I guess. When I first applied to Spotlight, I didn't understand the full scope of just everything that it was. To me, Spotlight is a really lovely community, artistic bubble of brilliance, and I'm very grateful to be here and a part of it. Hey, Michael, you got this. If you didn't, you wouldn't be here. You're gonna kill it out there, and I love you. Remember that. You're pretty cool in my book, so show them what I see.
Playing the role of Josh, a young man whose romantic relationship wasn't what he thought it was, in a scene from The Perfect Couple, please welcome Michael Davis.
Ha!
My ex-girlfriend, Claire, she lives in Amsterdam, and I'm not supposed to know that. Know how I know it? I read her email. I broke into her account, which I know is like really bad and like ethically fucked up. It's her own fault. She uses the same passwords for everything, and she doesn't change. It's her middle name. Anyway, so I pirated my way into Claire's Hotmail account one day, and there was this email from her best friend, and it was all like, "Oh my God, it's so cool that you're in Amsterdam with." And then the whole story, the other guy, the whole story. See, this is why you're not supposed to do shit like this. Like, there's some kind of, like, karmic penalty. Like, you get what you deserve. Like, you find out she's in some really strange place with a really strange dude with money and dreadlocks. Sometimes you're just not supposed to know what you're not supposed to know. You know? I mean Amsterdam? It's a fucking cliche.
Oh, I think we've all had some relationships like that. Well, hopefully not that bad. I'm glad you were only acting, Michael. Okay, I'd like to introduce our next performer, our grand prize finalist in classical instrumental, pianist Andrew Shi. Andrew is 17 and a senior at Diamond Bar High School. This is Andrew's fourth year participating in Spotlight. He studies piano with Rufus Choi and Ning An and thanks them for their efforts that have helped him make it here tonight. Let's meet Andrew.
I started playing the piano when I was 5 years old because I couldn't sit still as a kid, and as a way for my parents to keep me focused on a single task, they told me to start practicing the piano. When I play the piano, I feel completely immersed and able to imagine what the composer was trying to convey in his music. I think music is more than just notes on paper. It's a way for performers to convey an emotion to any audience. And through that emotion, no matter what background we come from, we're able to come together and share an experience. I think the biggest challenge that I've had to overcome being a musician is being able to fully express myself on stage. I've always been sort of an introvert, but I think through music I've really learned to be able to show everything that I know about my pieces and tell that to all of my audiences. In addition to music, I'm oddly obsessed with Rubik's Cubes. And as a cuber, although I'm not the fastest world record holder, I love studying different algorithms to solving different types of Rubik's Cubes. I love solving the triangle, the pyramid, everything Rubik's Cube related. In 10 years, I would really love to be continuing with classical performance, but also doing research on musical sounds and different ways to create sound and silence. Spotlight is a competition that is different than many others. The producers and everyone who supports Spotlight has definitely made me feel included in a greater music community. I'm able to talk with them, and that's actually very rare at many competitions. Andrew, you're about to walk on stage. Be creative, be expressive. This is your moment.
Performing Scherzo No. 3 in C sharp minor, a grand, stylistic, and astonishingly beautiful piece written by Frederick Chopin, it is now my pleasure to welcome to the stage Andrew Shi.
Seriously, with each and every performance, I find myself moved in a different way. Thank you, Andrew. That was absolutely incredible. Next, it's my pleasure to introduce our second grand prize finalist in ballet, Sophia Koo. Yes, more ballet. Her first time in Spotlight, 14-year-old Sophia is a freshman at Arnold O. Beckman High School and Tustin Connect High School. She's thankful for her teachers, Salwa Rizkala and Galina Barinova, for providing the training and performance opportunities that have helped her grow and flourish. A little note, I actually got the opportunity to share the stage with her a few years back in the Nutcracker, and it's just amazing to see where she is now. So let's get to know Sophia.
I started dancing when I was 4 years old. Ever since I was little, I would always dress up in a tiara and a tutu and dance around the house, so my parents saw how much I loved to move and dance, so they brought me to my first Mommy and Me dance class at a community center. I think from the beginning, I wasn't the most talkative person, so I think dancing was my way of talking almost, because I was able to express myself through the movement instead of through my speech. So it was just easier for me to share my emotions through dance rather than talking. What I love about dancing is probably the attention to detail it requires. It's a never-ending process, which I love because I think having the mindset of always having something to improve on is really beneficial. One of my biggest challenges has been to learn how to not compare myself to others. It's really hard, especially with social media nowadays and how easy it is just to scroll and see what other people are doing. But I've learned to just compare yourself to your past self, because that's the only thing that matters. Aside from dancing, I love to bake. What I love about baking is that you get to experiment with different ingredients and recipes, and I think it's really fun getting to explore and venture out, which is so different from ballet because you have to follow certain steps and techniques. So it's fun to do something different from time to time. Spotlight means the world to me because just the opportunities they have provided have been like no other, and all the people are amazing. Jerry, the staff, the judges, and all the other finalists are just so supportive and positive, which just makes the whole process so much more fun and enjoyable. Sophia, just remember that you got this and just perform as you always do. Just dance your heart out and know that all your friends and family are here supporting you. So just do what you love and everybody else will love it too.
Playing a noble child who is kidnapped and raised as a gypsy, Sophia performs the female variation from Paquita. Please welcome Sophia Koo.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sophia. What amazes me is how she makes it look so effortless. Let me tell you, it's not. Tyler just tried to show me how to stand in ballet. I couldn't even stand right. They want you to tear an ACL on the way, so. Just goes to show how impressive an entire performance is. Before we meet our next performer, I want to take a moment to introduce you to our Spotlight musical director, Jamie Tate. This is Jamie's 10th anniversary working on the show. The first Spotlight finale he conducted was right here in the Amundsen in 2012. Jamie, thank you for your contributions to Spotlight and the band for your work here tonight. Now, let's meet our next performer, a junior at Vistamar School, our grand prize finalist in jazz instrumental, 17-year-old drummer, Sophia Papachado. This is her second year as a Spotlight performer, and she wants to give thanks to her teachers, Taylor Kennedy and James Gamer. Now, let's get to know more about Sophia.
I started drumming when I was about 10.
It sounds like cliche, but the sounds that like a drum make, it's like satisfying. It's like fun to hold the music together. Drumming and percussion is the oldest instrument there is, so there's something in every human that can play drums. Whenever someone says, I don't have rhythm or something, it's like, come on, that's not true. I mean, it is difficult, and you do have to practice it to where you feel good enough. Don't practice too much, but practice. I think over-practicing leads to burnout, like lack of passion. And you really grow when you play instruments with other people, because that's what it's all about. I'm definitely not someone who's like obsessed with playing drums 24/7. I get really inspired by watching soccer. As cliche as it might sound, like I get a lot of inspiration from music watching like players that I really love. Watching Lionel Messi, who's the best player in the world, it's like, yeah, he's just so good at what he does and he's so cool with it. So if you can bring that energy to music, it's over. It just makes it that much better. One of the biggest takeaways for me from Spotlight is auditioning experience and learning how to play to my ability at an audition despite the nerves. The first one I did this time, my left leg was like shaking. I was afraid I wasn't gonna be able to control the hi-hat very well. But yeah, that slowly disappeared the more auditions I did. Okay, Sophia, just go and play drums. You know how to do it. Just go and play your song. Everyone will like it. I know you can do it. Let's go.
Performing Amanecer, let's welcome Sophia Papachado. Thank you.
Please welcome the Frederick Roberts Director of Spotlight, Jerry Gale.
We are back, and I'm so excited to be in this beautiful theater for our live grand finale performance after 3 years. And I want you to join me in thanking our incredible hosts, Tyler Peck and Rhenzy Feliz. I want to personally thank them for helping us shine the spotlight on these up-and-coming artists. And I would love now to have Andrew Shih, who you saw earlier, join me. Hi, Andrew.
Hi, Jerry.
You were really good.
Thanks, Jerry.
Right? Really good. Andrew's had a little bit of experience in Spotlight. How many years have you participated?
All 4 years of high school.
Okay, so like, clearly the next question for me is, what kept you coming back?
I think Spotlight has really been a life-changing experience for me, and it's a program that's really different than anything I've participated in. There's so many workshops, opportunities to connect with jury members, and ways to learn about your playing, and also just to really connect with the music community at Spotlight. And I think it's helped me grow both as an individual and also as someone who is situated in a greater music community. And on top of that, of course, there's so many opportunities to win scholarships.
We love scholarships. You're graduating this year, right?
That's correct.
Okay, so where are we going in the fall?
I'll be attending Stanford University, and I'm planning to... And I'm planning to study music, computer science, and economics.
Awesome. Well, Andrew did such a great job of talking about Spotlight, but if you want to learn more, look what I have. It's your program. And you can find lots of information about Spotlight in your program, as well as information on a new program beginning this year for young people who are interested in careers offstage. This is where we're really going to help and work with students to translate their abilities into professional careers in the creative and entertainment industries, because we know that creatives need to bring important skills to the table, such as resiliency, curiosity, adaptability, communication, and a sense that
the show must go on.
There you go. All right, so thank you so much for being here tonight, giving your love and support to the Spotlight program. We so appreciate it, and enjoy the rest of your evening.
Thank you, Jerry and Andrew. Now for our next performer, our second grand prize finalist in non-classical voice, Elias Robles. You hear that? A first-timer to Spotlight, 17-year-old Elias is a senior at Los Altos High School. He would like to thank his teachers, Dr. James Lint and Jeffrey Fahey, for their love and support. Let's get to know Elias.
I started singing when I was 6 years old. I was usually just trying to put on a show for my family in my living room. I would like put on musicals, one-man shows, of course. I love singing because it's just another form of storytelling. I really love the way that a performer and a singer can connect with the audience member by sharing their story and sharing what they want to be heard through their voice. There's something really unique about putting your own personal experiences, your own personal history, and your background into what you're singing, into the story that you're trying to tell. My grandpa Raphael really inspires me. I never met him. He died before I was born, but he was actually an opera singer. He actually performs at the Dorothy Chandler Pavilion. So it's definitely a crazy full circle moment to be performing at the Music Center. Aside from singing, I'm obsessed with collecting CDs and records. A lot of people are just throwing away or donating their CDs from the 2000s and 90s. So one man's trash is another man's treasure, and that's exactly what's happening with my CD collection. In 10 years from now, I definitely see myself still performing on stage, but I'd love to open a theater company that's a safe space for artists from underrepresented communities to present their works. We're definitely seeing a lot more opportunities for marginalized communities, but there always can be more. Spotlight to me is definitely a way for young artists to explore what they love and to further what they love and to put their passion into action. Working with the judges and the master's class instructors has definitely shown me that there's always room for growth and there's always room to keep exploring your material. It's something that you're always told, but you don't really realize how effective it is until you see it in action with the other contestants, so it's been really inspiring. Elias, this is a big moment, so take your time, take advantage of this opportunity, and channel your inner stalker.
Now, with a different kind of love song, please welcome Elias Robles singing to excess.
Hi, Claire. Claire, hi. Hi, Claire. Claire, hi. 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 Oh. Hey there, Claire. Ooh. Let me explain. I will show you that I'm not insane. Listen, Claire, and you'll see we are destiny. Claire, I need you around me. That's why I broke in your place. That's why you came home and found me with your panties pressed to my face. Claire, you may not recall the day that we met, but it's a day I'll never forget. The Stop and Shop produce aisle, I got all wrapped up in your smile. 'Cause Claire, I bumped right into your leg with my cart, and that bump started a song in my heart. You turned and said, "What the hell?" And well, Claire, that's the moment I fell. If it's a crime to follow a girl all the way home and memorize her address, then I guess I am guilty of loving you to excess. Claire, I may not be in very good shape, but I can climb a fire escape. And I don't even mind that you shut your living light. Ooh, 'cause Claire, I bought a real nice camera with zoom, and found me a tree with a view of your room. And Claire Bear, it makes me weep that you look so cute when you sleep. If it's a crime to take some pictures of a girl in various states of undress, then I guess I am guilty of loving you to excess. I see you eyeing up that window there, but Claire, let me speak. I'm not some psycho like that guy you took to Chili's last week. He didn't even try to open up the door for you as you left the bar, and so I hit that asshole with my car. And Claire, on Sundays I'll unlock you from your chain. We'll have a nice dinner, we'll sip champagne, we'll make sweet love all night long, just you and me and my mom. If it's a crime to hold a girl's grandmother hostage until she agrees to say yes, then I guess I am guilty. I confess I am guilty. Like sentenced to life. Guilty of loving you to excess. So what do you say, Claire?
A stalker love song. Weird, funny, and a little scary. From there, let's move on to our second grand prize finalist in dance, a 15-year-old sophomore at ASU Prep Digital, Tegan Chu. This is her first time participating in Spotlight. Tegan trains under teachers Megan Guise and Dimitri Kuliv and thanks them for supporting her in her journey. Let's hear from Tegan.
Originally, I fell in love with ballet because I love being very logical and analytical. And I feel like with ballet, it's the perfect combination of trying to remember the steps and musicality and timing and precision. And when I started doing contemporary, I realized that I could still incorporate all of my love for ballet and start using more artistry and more expression and more movement. And I love performing because when I step on stage, it's like everything I'm worried about and everything I'm thinking about just disappears. And as soon as I leave the stage, I just want to go right back on there. I definitely have a sense of competitiveness, but I think it's healthy and encourages me to be a better dancer. Like if I see somebody else doing something really well, I'm like, oh, I want to be like that. And I'll work harder and try to be better than them. Something people might not know about me is that I love bullet journaling and calligraphy. I have like an obsession with colored pens, and I had always loved creating to-do lists and planners and calendars when I was a kid. And I really like math, because there's always something that my brain needs to be thinking of, like what formula should I use for this? What steps should I follow? And when I put it all together, it's kind of satisfying because then you get your answer to your problem. I feel like this is the same with dance because, you know, if you're performing on stage, you have to think, am I too far? Am I too back? Am I dancing in sync with my friends? And then when you remember it all, then you get something beautiful and it's fun to watch. I was actually really sick when I found out that I won grand prize finalist, so I didn't think it was real and I was completely shocked. But when it hit me, I was so inspired and I found this new sense of confidence in me from that. I can't believe I'm part of the Spotlight family now. And there's alumni like Misty Copeland. She's a ballerina I've always looked up to. That's incredible and it makes me feel so inspired and excited. Thank you to the sponsors and donors of the Spotlight program. I think it is so important that we keep inspiring and nourishing the arts community, especially after the pandemic. I'm so glad I get to be part of such an amazing experience. Okay, Tegan, you can do this. Just go out there and have fun and enjoy every moment on stage and don't fall.
Performing Deliverance, please welcome to the stage, Tegan Chu.
I
Wow. Another impressive performance, along with all the other wonderful young artists we've seen tonight.
I know, it's been so nice having the night off from dancing and getting just to watch the next generation and from the wings. I'm so inspired not only by their talent and skill, but by the fact that given all the challenges over the last few years, they've managed to thrive and let their creativity grow.
It gives me hope that no matter what obstacles they face in life, they have the skills it takes to triumph.
Now, before we meet our last performer, I'd like to acknowledge everyone who made the Spotlight 2022 Grand Finale performance possible, our finalists and their terrific families.
The Music Center, our production team, and our supportive and generous donors, thank you.
Now, our final performer is our second grand prize finalist in classical instrumental, violinist Ashley Tai. Ashley is 16 and a senior at Colburn Music Academy, where she studies with Henry Gronier and Catherine Corvino, who she thanks for their guidance and support. This is Ashley's first year participating in Spotlight. Let's meet her.
I started playing the violin when I was 5 years old, mainly because I loved music, first of all. My parents loved music. Music was around my entire life. What I love about the violin is that there's endless possibilities to explore. Like, there are no two same ways to play a single phrase. Like, every single time you play it is going to be different. And I think that's something really special because you can do a lot of experimenting and trying to figure out what you really like in the practice room. So there's always something new that you can try. And I also think that it's a way for you to really express yourself in a lot of different ways that no other person can really copy. When I first pick up the violin, it's like super natural. I don't really feel out of place. It almost becomes like an extension. I know I can put everything I have into the violin and it's gonna be there to support me. Aside from music, I really enjoy running or working out and stretching and doing yoga. I think I started really easing into that during the COVID pandemic, and it was something that would like take my mind off of practicing or like be a practice break. I would just go out for a run or like do some yoga. And I think it has really helped me because it clears my mind. It gives me a break from all the music that's like around me at all times. I think this Spotlight experience has really helped me grow as a musician. I think the fact that it was over an entire year really gave me the opportunity to have something to look forward to have something to grow, to rise to that occasion. And because of like the programming, I also had the chance to like explore so many different genres of music and like to explore so many different ideas. Everything that Spotlight has given me has really just helped inspire me as a musician as well. Ashley, you got this. Just remember to breathe and just walk out there and be you.
Performing Prokofiev's Concerto No. 1 in D major, please welcome Ashley Tai.
Thank you.
Okay, now, before we bring the performers out, I want everyone to first turn on your cell phones, take your cameras, and get ready for pictures.
And while you're doing that, I want to encourage the high school artists out there to apply today for the 2023 Music Center Spotlight Program.
Yes, applications are now available on our website. Go to musiccenter.org/spotlight. You can also find us on Instagram at Music Center Spotlight, both of which are listed in your guys' programs.
Okay, are we ready? Good. Please join me now in welcoming back to the stage our grand prize finalists.
As we close, we want to congratulate all of our grand prize finalists, as well as all the young artists who participated in this year's Spotlight program.
And we want to thank you for being a part of the Spotlight family. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you.
Exhilarating thing that's ever happened to me.
It was so good.
It just felt really good.
Surreal. Unbelievable.
The stage and the lights and the people, and I loved it so much. It was nerve-wracking, but I'm happy with my performance. That felt so good.
Thank you.
Oh, it felt great. I loved it.
I felt great, honestly. Like, that was really awesome getting to play for all those people.
It's super exciting.
It was really good. Thank you so much for this amazing opportunity. I had so much fun on stage.
The audience was amazing. I didn't expect it to be that loud.
I did it.
I'm grateful for everything.
Yeah, I was just so thankful for this opportunity. So, yeah, thank you so much, Spotlight.
I'm so grateful I got to have this opportunity. I had the best time. Thank you, Spotlight. Thank you, donors. I'm so, so, so grateful for you.